Hi. In the last video, we took a list of participants, we serialized them, and we stored the serialized data in a file. You can see it right here. This time, we are going to deserialize. We take this very data right here, and based on that, we're going to recreate the list of participants. So I'm going back to my serialization demo, and I'm going to add a second method. It's called deserialize. It's also public, but the return type is not void. This time we're going to recreate a list of participants, and that is what we're going to return. So my return type is a list of participants. The name of my method is called deserialize, and my method deserialize needs a certain information to be able to do the job. It needs the file name so it knows where it can find the serialized data. The Java API provides a class that does deserialization. It is called Object Input Stream. So I'm going to create an instance of Object Input Stream. Call it in, and I'm going to initialize it with a new object input stream. The object input stream knows how to take a series of bytes and how to recreate an object based on that series of bytes. However, it needs a second object that knows how to come up with this series of bytes in the first place. In our case, the data is coming from a file. So we need an object that can open a file and read the content as a series of bytes. A class that can do that is file input stream. So we're going to create an instance of file input stream. New file input stream. File input stream can open a file and read the content as a series of bytes if we tell file input stream where the file is. So we have to provide a file name. That's what we're going to do right here. And at this point, I have at the very end a red wiggly line. It reminds me there should be a semicolon, and the moment I provide my semicolon, I get another reminder. And we know that already. It is an unhandled checked exception. We have two choices. We can either declare the exception or we can have a try-catch block. I'm going to have a try-catch block, and once again we're going to use a try with resource statement because object input stream implements auto-closable. So here we have try, we're going to have the declaration and instantiation of our object input stream surrounded by parentheses and directly followed by the body of the try block. Also, we're going to write the catch block right next to it, and we're going to use it to catch the IO exception. Before I do the actual deserialization, I'm going to create a variable where I can store the result. Deserialize is going to return the list of participants. So I'm going to create my list of participants right here, list participant, and I just call it plist, and I initialize it with null. And then I'm going to return it at the very end. This means if I was not able to deserialize, then I'm going to return null, otherwise I'm going to return the actual list. In my try block, I'm going to do the deserialization. I'm going to use my object input stream in with a dot operator, and now I say read, and you can see there's a whole number of different read methods: read object, read boolean, read char, read double, etc. We're going to use read object because we use to serialize an object. What I can deserialize depends on what I actually serialized before. So in our case, we serialized a list of participants. Now I have to deserialize a list of participants. If I say in.readObject, the object input stream is going to interpret the sequence of bytes as a serialized object. It's going to recreate an object based on the sequence of bytes. However, I need a list of participants. I'm going to cast it back to what it actually is. It's a list of participants. And now I'm going to assign it to my plist. I can see that there's yet another unhandled checked exception. It is a class not found exception. I don't want to have special treatment for that, so I'm going to declare it right next to my IO exception. I can say it can be an IO exception or it can be a class not found exception. And if I encounter one of those two exception types, then I want to print a message to the user. I'm also going to print the original message from the exception. I'm going to change this original message. I'm going to say serialization done. I'm going to move it a little closer to my serialization code. And now I'm going to create a new list of participants. And I call it new list. And I'm going to assign it the newly created list that we reconstructed with the deserialization. So here I say demo deserialize. And I can see this is going to be too long. Let's move it in the next line. We're going to pass the exact same file name that we had before. And I'm going to have a semicolon at the end. And it would be nice to actually print the list. So here I'm going to print my list system out. Print line, new list. And I'm going to print the new list. So let's see how this is going to look like. I'm going to run it. I'm going to change my view so I can see my output. Let's make this a little bit bigger. And we can see we had an original list of participants, then we serialized, serialization was done, and then based on the data we stored in a file, we recreated a new list, and the new list is exactly the same as my original list.